The radon process performs a forward or reverse radon transform using a linear, hyperbolic, or parabolic model. We will use the radon transform in a robust workflow to remove multiples from our gathers. The result will be post-migration gathers ready for making angle stacks. The best parameters will vary depending on the input data. This workflow requires post-migration NMO-corrected gathers. This example has some very obvious multiples from around 4,200 milliseconds that need removing. First, we'll remove the area of NMO stretch from the gathers using a mute. A 60-degree outer mute works well. Create a new mute gathers process. Select the input volume. Set the outer mute and QC the results. Let's focus on the deeper section to see the multiples. Create a new automatic gain AGC process to normalize the amplitudes. For example, use a 250 millisecond window with a 20% overlap. The resulting volume might need the min-max display values adjusting. Create a new frequency domain radon process. Set the direction as forward and select the AGC volume. Set the offset value or calculate the offset from the source and group coordinates. The parabolic model is the best choice for removing these strong multiples, but there are also linear and hyperbolic options for addressing different types of noise. Set a sensible modeling range by measuring the observed move-out in milliseconds at the defined reference offset of 5,000 meters. For this dataset, a modeling range minus 300 to 1200 milliseconds will be sufficient. Leave the start time blank to model from the beginning of the trace. The number of P traces determines the resolution of the transform. More traces creates a more detailed result, but takes longer to run. Optionally, set the frequency range as required. Here, a high pass filter with F1 set as 0 and F2 set as 5 Hz removes any low frequency noise. Adjust the zoom of the horizontal axis to show the P domain gather, and update the display range. Remember, increasing P traces improves the resolution, but also adds to runtime. Create a polygon around the middle section of the P domain. This corresponds to the flat primary signal that we want to preserve. The points outside the polygon correspond to dipping events. Create a new polygon mute process. Mute inside the polygon, leaving behind only parabolic multiples. Create a new frequency domain radon process. Set the direction to reverse. This returns the noise model to the offset domain. Display the noise model and adjust the amplitude range as required. Only dipping noise events should be displayed. The mute polygon must be adjusted if flat signal is showing. Create a new volume math simple process. Divide the noise model by the AGC scalars to match the amplitudes to the original gather volume. Create another volume math simple process. subtract the noise model from the original gather volume. The result is a multiple-free gather. QC the results to check you haven't lost any primary signal. Change the polygon mute from inside polygon to outside polygon, creating the inverse operation, showing only the noise as a result. Don't forget to change the polygon mute back to the correct setting when you're satisfied. If you have questions or would like to discover more, then visit our website at www.dug.com. And remember, have fun with Insight!